Azure PlayFab Multiplayer Servers provides you with the infrastructure to host multiplayer games, and the latest VmStartupScript feature enables you to automate tasks to configure and customize those game servers before use. Dimitri Garnatsios is here today to show me how this works on Microsoft Game Dev Connect. Hi everyone, I'm Joanna Lee and welcome to Microsoft Game Dev Connect. I'm here with Dimitri Garnatsios, who is going to share with me about the latest VmStartupScript feature. How are you doing today, Dimitri?
Hey, Joanna, I'm excited to be here.
I'm happy to have you here today as well. Dimitri, before we start talking about the latest VmStartupScript, can you share with me a little bit more about PlayFab Multiplayer Servers and how does it help creators and developers?
PlayFab Multiplayer Servers, or for short we call it MPS, is a server hosting service optimized for game servers. It enables you to dynamically scale your custom game servers according to player demand. It's built on Azure Compute, so you can think of it like a globally distributed cloud service that offers a broad range of compute capacity.
Oh, so basically PlayFab Multiplayer Servers helps developers make it easier, right, for them to create multiplayer games. So tell me more about this VmStartupScript and why did you create it?
The way the service works today is that you have to create what we call a build, which is a special version of your game server along with several parameters like, for example, the regions you want to deploy your game server to. With this setup, it's not easy for customers to do modifications on their underlying VM hosting their game servers. That's why we released the feature. It's in preview. We call it, as you said, VmStartupScript. And this enables you to launch a script just before your game servers run.
So what can I use this script for? And, you know, maybe share me some examples on how I can use it.
Mm-hmm. So on the private preview, we have been working with several internal and external partners. We have seen them do various interesting things. So, for example, they can install a custom software that is necessary for the operation of their game servers. They can configure monitoring and logging infrastructure. We're going to show a demo for it later. And they can also install custom firewalls, crash dump utilities, or launch custom profilers to identify performance bottlenecks on their game server.
Oh, great that you can do so many things with it. So how do I start using this feature and if there are any requirements, right, when using the script?
Let me walk you through our documentation.
Mm-hmm.
So the feature is currently in preview, so it's only available through our APIs for the time being.
Okay.
So we have the create build APIs, which basically allow you to create a Linux or Windows build.
Okay.
Here we're going to show a sample on the create build with custom container API. It creates a Linux build.
Okay.
Some parameters here, like the container image we want to use, the type of the VM, the ports, and which regions you want to launch your game server in. And the key part is here, where basically you are referencing a zip file, which you have already uploaded to PlayFab.
Okay.
This zip file must contain a specially named file for Windows and, well, depending on the operating system you run. For Linux, you can write your script on bash, and for Windows, we recommend PowerShell.
Okay.
And on that zip file, you can also bundle any other software you want to install on the virtual machine.
Mm-hmm. So this looks really good. And so do you have any templates, right, that make it easier for us to use?
Yes, definitely. So along with the feature, we launched an open source repository on GitHub.
Mm-hmm.
It's called VM Startup Script Gallery.
Mm-hmm.
And it has what we call recipes for that basically allow people to create their own their own startup scripts.
Mm-hmm.
So we can see this one. This one is a Linux recipe, uses Telegraph, which is a popular open source agent for collecting and reporting metrics with many inputs and outputs, and works with one of the outputs it works with is Azure Data Explorer or Kusto. Kusto is a fast, fully managed data service on Azure that basically can ingest and query massive amounts of data. So let me show you the Telegraph configuration file. So Telegraph is configured to grab logs from the containers, the game servers running on the virtual machine. And it is also configured to capture important virtual machine performance metrics like CPU, memory, network, and output, export all this data to Custo. Custo has a developer portal which can you can use to query your tables. So that table.log here contains the logs from our game server. We can see here that this game server logged this message. We can see here the version of the game server, the timestamp, and we can also see here metrics like CPU and memory. Importantly, for the metrics, for the virtual machine performance metrics, because it's a bit hard to visualize them here on this table, we have created some Custo dashboards that you can see here. Let me refresh this. And you can see how these metrics are getting modified through time. So you can see here the processor usage on user space and kernel space, percentage of available memory and disk use, number of disk writes, network, etc., etc. And we have created some filters. You can pick the region, you can pick a specific virtual machine. If you think that, you know, a specific virtual machine has performance issues, you can pick it here and understand what's going on. And if you have multiple builds or, for example, multiple versions of your game server deployed, you can compare it here side by side.
That's cool. You know, I really like that the script, you know, you can link it to Custo, Azure Data Explorer, and then you have a dashboard, right, to visualize this data. So that's awesome. Before I let you go, you know, I'm pretty sure the audience wants to know if there are any limitations when using this script and what should I not use it for?
So the script runs with administrative privileges. So what I like to say, with great power comes great responsibility. So you should not, for example, compromise on the security of your virtual machine. I mean, the VM is pretty locked down, but still, you know, you're running as admin, so there are things that you can do. The services launched from your script should not consume a lot of CPU and memory, because you want this essentially for your game servers. And importantly, the script execution must be fast, because you want the script to finish as quickly as possible so we can launch your game servers. For that reason, we also recommend, if you want to install custom software on the VM, to bundle the software in the zip file and not download on the fly.
Thanks for sharing these tips and, you know, and these limitations, right? Beforehand, if there's a recipe I want to use, but it's not in GitHub today, what can I do about it?
Yeah. So you can create an issue on the repository, and either us or the community can work on it. You can also send us a message on PlayFab forums on the game dev Discord. And if you want to create a recipe of yourself, we highly encourage pull requests.
Oh, cool. Wonderful. I can create my own recipe and share them with you too. So lastly, if I want to try out PlayFab Multiplayer Service, how can I do that?
So once you get a PlayFab account, you can visit Game Manager, which is our developer portal. It's very easy there to enable MPS. And once you do that, you can take advantage of our free tier that allows you to evaluate the service in a couple of regions.
Okay, fantastic. I will try this out. Thank you so much, Dimitri, for sharing with me about PlayFab Multiplayer Service today and the latest VM Startup Script.
Thank you for having me.
I hope you have enjoyed this episode. Thank you all for joining me today to learn about VM Startup Script in PlayFab Multiplayer Servers on Microsoft Game Dev Connect.